happy showers of blessings. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops from the stars falling, but for the showers we plead. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops from the stars falling, but for the showers we shall be showers of blessing, send them upon us, O Lord. Run to us now, a refreshing, come and now honor thy word. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we from the stars falling, but for the showers we plead. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops from the stars falling, but for the showers we plead.
When we forget our worries and hope for a prosperous and happy life. It is the hour to celebrate and make merry with friends and family. The Christmas spirit is about loving and giving and forgiving. But wait, has it touched us all? Let me tell you the story of one, Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge, who didn't believe in Christmas at all.
Merry Christmas, Uncle. I was just on my way to see you. Come to Christmas dinner. We are inviting you, Sally and I. Be with family, Uncle. Just this once. We would really like it if you would visit. What right have you to be dismal? You're rich enough. Don't be cross, Uncle. Christmas time is kind, forgiving, charitable and pleasant. Though it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pockets, I believe it has done me good. And I say, God bless it. Anyway, a Merry Christmas to you.
Bah, humbug. Don't bother. Thank you. Merry Christmas. What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough. What's Christmas time but a time for paying bills without money? A time to find yourself an hour older, but not a day richer. If I could work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips should be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holy through his heart. He should! Marrying for love? I do not want to celebrate with a fool and his family. God bless it. Well, I don't normally do this, but out of the kindness of my heart, no. You see, you're always complaining about how you need more money, Bob. So you should be delighted, no, thrilled to work on Christmas so you can earn the money. This so-called Christmas spirit and kindness and holiday spirit and spending time with your loved ones. Humbug! It sounds like a bunch of baloney to me. Fine, Bob. Take tomorrow off. No pay. If you change your mind, I'll be here doing some thrilling paperwork. I'll whip up some of my famous sardines. It'll be a party.
That's a very tempting offer, sir. But I'm afraid I'll have to pass. Have a very Merry Christmas, boss.
Christmas. Bah, humbug. What a worthless time of the year. God bless it.
What do you want of me? take a Marley. But now, I have been doomed to wander the earth, chained up and dead. I come to you with a warning. I live my life focused on nothing but wealth and possessions. I was a greedy man. I see you walking down the same path here today. You will be visited by three ghosts. If you don't listen to them and change your ways, your spirit will wander around just like me. Except carrying even heavier chains this time.
No one can change me. Especially not you and these three ghosts. I live my life the way I live it. Bambag. I must have been dreaming. I'm overworked. I'm overtired. I'm going to bed. I'm going to bed.
I am the ghost of Christmas past, Ebenezer Scrooge. And this is your life.
Scrooge holds a photo frame of his sister and looks into it. It shows him the events of his past. He sees how he lost his father, who was imprisoned for non-payment of debts. He was heartbroken to be separated from him.
He remembers his father's words.
Save your penny, Scrooge.
Make your fortune from it. He continues to look into the photo and sees his mother had died soon after and his sister was separated from him. He was left alone and spent many a lonely Christmas. Scrooge is whizzed into another scene from his past. He saw himself apprenticed in a bank where he had worked with Jacob Marley and had met Belle.
Oh, there's Mr. Fezziwig. Bless his heart. And Jacob Marley, my partner. Who's that? Belle?
I remember. Being such a happy young lad, Mr. Fezziwig was a generous employer, and I was so happy working for him. I think I've been the most unkind to Bob Cratchit. I would like to say a thing or two. I shall make amends. There's still time. I shall call him tomorrow. What do I see now? There's me dancing with Belle.
My dear Belle, we were engaged to be married. She was the most beautiful and loyal person to me.
Well, you lost her, didn't you? She returned your ring and went far away from you. Do you remember why?
In the prime of his life, Ebenezer Scrooge and Jacob Marley were business partners. The cash registers kept ringing as creditors lined up outside to borrow money, which was lent on one condition. The borrowed money needed to be paid back with interest. The hope of being beyond poverty had taken over all his other ambitions. In a bid to become rich, Ebenezer loses the love of his life, Belle.
She said she couldn't be engaged to me any longer. She said I was busy working and earning money all the time. I wish I had stopped her that day. I wish I had changed for her, for us.
We come to the present world that Ebenezer Scrooge lives in. And what does he see? His clerk, the poorly paid Bob Cratchit, is celebrating Christmas with his family. He has gone to attend the service at the church with his youngest child, Tiny Tim, who is very ill.
Must not die. tell me, pray tell me, that Tiny Tim will live.
It wasn't a merry toast, but I see a vacant chair and a crutch without an owner. If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, Tiny Tim will die. Scrooge, look at the future, the dark, bleak future.
Scrooge did not get an answer to his question, but the ghost of the future showed him the world where he saw Tiny Tim dead and his loving family sat crushed around his empty chair. What did Scrooge do to prevent this future from unfolding? Did the scenes he witnessed initiate within him a process of transformation?
I know I'm in the presence of the ghost of Christmas yet to come. You are about to show me the shadow of things that have not happened yet, but will happen in time before us, aren't you?
Yes, I'm here to take you to see the world where things are yet to happen. Come along, Scrooge, see what the world holds for you. Remember, you are responsible for what you see. Your future depends on your past and present.
The ghost of Christmas yet to come took Scrooge to a dismal, wretched, ruinous churchyard. The ghost stood among the graves and pointed down towards the grave. Scrooge crept towards it, trembling as he went, following the finger read upon the tombstone of the neglected grave, his own name, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Am I the man in this neglected grave? No, ghost, oh no, no, hear me. I am not the man I was. I will not be the man I must have been. Why show me this if I am past all hope? I want to change. I will honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year. Oh, tell me, I may sponge away the writing on the stone. Help me, I want to change. Don't abandon me, ghost. Christmas has given me a chance to change. I don't want to let it go.
Wakes up from his dream, and it is a bright and a sunny day, for it's Christmas Day. Scrooge is filled with hope, and his heart beats faster as he's eager to come out from the shadows of his dark and miserly ways and welcome the spirit of Christmas and live the rest of his life accordingly.
I shall send a turkey to my clerk Bob Cratchit's house for this Christmas dinner. He shan't know who sent it, and it will be twice the size of Tiny Tim.
Dressed himself all in his best and rushed to his office, where he found Bob Cratchit arriving late. Poor Bob trembled in fear when he saw Scrooge. But he was no longer the miserly Scrooge. He was a changed man. So what did Scrooge tell his clerk?
Ah, Bob, what do you mean by coming here at this time of the day?
Sorry, Mr. Scrooge. Sorry for being late. It is Christmas Day. It won't happen again.
You say you are sorry. Yes, I think you are. Now, I tell you what, my friend, I am not going to stand for this sort of thing any longer. And therefore, I am about to raise your salary. A Merry Christmas, Bob. A Merrier Christmas, my good fellow, than I have given you for many a year. I'll raise your salary and endeavor to assist your struggling family. It is indeed a beautiful Christmas.
Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all and infinitely more. And to Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was a second father. He became as good a friend, as good a master, and as good a man as the good old city knew. Some people laughed to see the alteration, but his own heart laughed, and that was quite enough for him. And it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well. May that be truly said of us. God bless us, everyone. Merry Christmas to all.
Presented before you an adaptation of Charles Dickens' immortal Christmas play, A Christmas Carol, that is all carry in our hearts the true spirit of the festival, of loving and sharing and making the world a better place. Thank you.
Joy to the world.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Navidad.